So now we've got our registration form and we've got our register action. So our register form sends these inputs out to the registration action. But what we need to do before we go any further is look at how the form deals with whatever this returns, because we can't guarantee that it's going to return a valid response. It may well be it returns the validate data error. It might well be that there's been a server error. It could be in some occasions there might be an authorization error. So we need to be able to deal with that, and also we need to deal with what happens once that register action has completed, because we don't want simply to be sitting on that same page thinking, okay, what on earth has happened. So I'm going to go back to register now. First thing we need to do is to tell the register page what to do in the event of the submit button being clicked, and in this case we're going to tell it we need server. It's going to be a server action form that is going to run, and then we need to select the server action that's going to run, which will be that register action. So now when they click that register button, these inputs are going to be sent to the server action. The server action is going to process test, and it's going to send a message back to the page, and it's going to send, we hope, a success message to say it has successfully created that user in the database, and then we can move on to another page as a direct consequence of that. So how do we detect whether there's been errors sent back to the page or whether it's been successful? We do that within the dynamic events. So we have a dynamic event and server connect, and you'll see here that there are various predefined server connection responses which we can trap, and then we can deal with them accordingly. So we're going to start with what happens if, say, the server has indicated there was an error. We need to be able to tell the user that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a component called notifications. Now there are several ways of interacting with the user in these circumstances. Notifications is a fairly common one, and if I just hit Control S, you'll see a little green confirmation pop up in Wappler to say the file was saved successfully. In this case, Wappler's chosen to show it in the bottom and align to the right. I'm going to position ours in the top, aligned to the right. Alternatives we could use is something called Bootstrap Toasts. And the toasts, again, we can find here. Toasts are a little more complicated in terms of they actually have that like a little info box that pops up. They have a title, they can potentially have an image, they can have a quite a lengthy message attached. We won't be using those at this stage. And then the last one is actually there are also in the blocks some modals for error, success, video and warning, so that you could actually say, well, pop up a complete dynamic modal on your screen to say there's been an error or a success. Again, a little bit over the top for what we need. All we need to do is pop up a message saying error, unauthorized, or deal with a success event. So we're back into, make sure you selected the form itself. We're going to dynamic events, server connect, and we'll deal with error first. We're now going to use the picker here. So you know this is the basic actions. This is something called flows, which is a lot more complicated, a lot more sophisticated, probably a better word, and we'll be dealing with those soon, but for the moment let's just click that little triangle there. And what we're telling it is, in the event of an error, I want to see the danger notification, which by default in Bootstrap is red, albeit of course you could have redefined that. And I just wanted to pop up a message saying, let's say, oops, an error, a occurred. Now, as we go through, we'll be adding basically this danger warning, an unauthorized warning, and a success message to pretty well every form that we create. So get the idea of it, because at one point or later on, I'm going to be saying, okay, now just add those warning and danger actions, and expect you to be able to do that, because it's going to get really boring if you have to watch me do this on every occasion. So there's our error event. We can add multiple events here though, so we're now going to say our unauthorized event. This probably shouldn't happen because there's no security involved there, but it's a really good habit to get into to do this. So notifications, I'm going to use the warning, which is traditionally orange within the basic Bootstrap definition, and we're just going to say unauthorized. And then lastly, I'm sorry, my computer seems to be running a little bit sluggish today for some reason. Lastly, we're going to be looking at a success event, and that's an all-important one. Success means, yes, I've done everything that you want to do, that person is registered, and what we're going to do is we're going to take them to the home page at the moment, and we're just going to clear this form. So how are we going to do that? Well, we need to add another component first, and that component is called the browser. The notifications and browser components are probably the components you will use most within Wappler, because when we have a success response, then what I want to do is, first of all, I want to just reset that form, so our register form is reset, so we cleared it, just as a tidy up really. And then I want to go to, and then we're going to use the routing panel here, and we're going to route it to our homepage. Simple as that, which is the root there, that single slash. We can define it as an internal link. In other words, we don't need to reload that layout page, and we're just going to call that homepage. That's the title that will appear in your web browser when you are viewing the page. I think we've covered everything now, so all that really remains to do is to hit the save button. Let's open this in a browser. So we've got the icon up here, open in browser. Just drag that onto the page because it's opened up on my other monitor. Right, my name is Brian English. My email is going to be test@test.com. Remember I said it has to be valid structure. It's obviously an invalid email, but the structure of it's correct, so it will accept that. I'm just going to put 8 ones. We're going to confirm that with another 8 ones. We have to accept the terms and conditions. I'm now going to open the developers panel, the developers tool, because this is really important that we've got to look at the errors if there's a problem and see exactly what it is. Let's hit the register button, and if all's gone well, yeah, you see we've had a successful network action there. The register action is run, it's returned that status of 200 to say it's successful, and it has diverted us to our home page. That's exactly what we wanted to happen. And if we now go into our database manager and we view the data in our tables, so I'm going to review edit data, you'll see that that information has been inserted into our action and our data sign up, and we also have a role. Anybody notice the big issue here? Well, the big issue was when we were looking at the user table, because you'll see that our password is not encrypted. And anybody who uses a non-encrypted password on the internet nowadays really needs to have a few words in that ear, I think is probably the polite way of putting it, because we didn't actually encrypt that password in our registration action. So what we're going to do is we've gone back to this now. I'm going to add a stage after this validate data. And we're going to use the cryptographic section. And we're going to hash that password. And what we're going to do is that password that we're going to hash is the content of the, sorry, not the email field, the password field. So we'll add that. So that will then take the password field and it will put apply the argon to ID algorithm and create a hash. So it means that when we go through this database insert here and our insert options, instead of inserting the password, we actually now want to insert the hashed version of the password. So it's our password hash. Click OK. Let's save that. Now let's just run our action again and see how we perform there. So let's open in browser. Bill Smith. Doesn't really matter. Testy1@test.com, just to make it unique. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 ones. We read and accepted, and there we are at our home page. That means that our action has run correctly. And now if we go into our users table, we should see something very different. Now we see now, instead of having a plain password, we have this encrypted password, which obviously is going to make life very difficult for any hackers to try and log into that account. So that's our form handling completed. That is how we have encrypted our password, and now we just need to add our anti-spam measures.